Renewable power is booming as innovation brings down costs and starts to deliver the promise of a clean energy future. Renewable energy is replacing dirty fossil fuels in the power sector, offering the benefit of lower emissions of carbon and other types of pollution. This information came from Laura Shin at the NRDC, which is the National Resource Defense Council, who is a nonprofit international environmental advocacy group in the United States. You may think that the energy you use from gasoline and propane may not be that big of a deal in CO2 emissions, but 85% of the world's energy consumption is from fossil fuels. This statistic is from Dr. Stuart J. Beardsworth, who has also written other papers about chemistry and science. This statistic may be scary for some, and that is why we need to do something about it soon. I can tell you that if I had the chance to live off renewable energy, I would. I love Earth and I love everything that there is to love about it, and I hope that my kids and my grandkids get to live here instead of going and living on Mars. You may be wondering why this is so important to you and how this would affect your life. So I've created a speech to inform you of these very things, and also what you can do to help with going green and the many different types of renewable energy that there is. Let's start with the different types of renewable energy. Shin says that according to the National Renewable Energy Laboratory, more energy comes to Earth from the sun in 1 hour than is used in the world in 1 year. Today, we use the sun's rays in so many different ways, to heat homes, businesses, even to heat water and charge your cell phones. Solar panels or panels are made from silicon and other materials that transform sunlight directly into energy. So when you have solar panels on top of your house, it's distributed to other homes as well, but it mostly stays in your home, but if other homes need it, then it'll go to them too. Thomas J. Hammonds is a graduate of the University of Glasgow, which has programs in the renewable energy fields. He states that renewable energy is generated from natural resources such as sunlight, wind, rain, tides, and geothermal heat, which are all naturally replenished. They are not depleted. In fact, they are remade by the earth. Shin explains the difference between hydroelectric, geothermal, and biomass energy, and where they can be found and harvested. So that's like a field of solar panels, which you see around here once in a while. And so this is hydroelectric power. Hydroelectric energy is harvested from large hydraulic plants like large dams. Fast-moving water from rivers can also create electricity, so that is also hydroelectric. And when water falls from great heights, it also creates energy. So like waterfalls and dams, they all are hydroelectric. Geothermal energy is created from the heat of the earth. Drilling deep wells brings very hot underground water to the surface as a hydrothermal resource, which is then pumped through a turbine to create electricity. Now this is biomass. Biomass energy is organic energy that comes from plants and animals. When biomass is burned, the chemical energy is released and heat can generate quickly with a steam turbine. So even wood is biomass, but when you burn wood, you get the smoke and the CO2 that comes from it, which can be harmful. So even renewable energy can be harmful to the planet. There is more we can do to help this planet than you actually think we can. Beardsworth explains that there is a special report by the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change that says with current efforts, a desired global rise cap of 1.5 degrees Celsius cannot be possible unless CO2 emissions decline a lot before the year 2030. And he also says that most countries should be CO2 neutral by the end of the first half of this century. Ali Saya, the editor of Chief in Renewable Energy, talks about the use of light in architecture. She says that we should think of light as a building material and how we should build structures around light. So instead of having these lights in this classroom, these could be like windows, or it's just glass, so then it allows extra light to come in and have these walls be windows, so then instead of using electricity, we can use the power that the sun gives us for light. Nail Alfera and Christophides Pantognos, those are quite the names, are writers from Science Direct, and they explain that California requires all retail sellers of electricity to serve 1/3 of their load of renewable energy by the year 2020. Harvesting on a large scale is actually a really big challenge. Future energy sustainability depends on how renewable energy problem is addressed in the next few decades. So my aunt Jody and Terry recently moved back out to California, and they live in Sacramento. And it's my uncle's big thing to say, we've gone solar, because he loves his solar panels. So they invested in solar panels and put it on their roof, and their energy cost has actually gone down, but you do have to pay for the solar panels, but over time you will get all that money back. And so they actually save a lot of money if they don't use any electricity from the hours of 10 in the morning to 6 at night. So when I was out there, he said I couldn't do laundry from 10 to 6. So I kind of had to reclose because I forgot to. But yeah, so that was like his big thing. Like I'd turn on the lights and he'd be like, you're using energy. And just back off. And they also bought a Tesla. So they bought the cheapest version of a Tesla, I guess, the new affordable model. And they actually use the power from their house that they generate with their solar panels to charge their Tesla and their Honda Hybrid. And gas is really expensive out there, if you didn't know. It's like $4 a gallon. And renewable energy is actually way more affordable than you think it is. It's common for renewable energy projects to make financial payments to local communities. And Kurt says that individual benefit arrangements can vary from situation to situation. Many houses that have solar on the East Coast have smaller electric bills because they do not use electricity during certain times of the day, like in California. So the cost of heat and electricity here in Minnesota can be pretty expensive. Electricity costs about $90 a month, but if you do solar power or other renewable energies, you can actually save $343 a year. And the cost of heat can be very expensive if you use like propane from Senex. It can cost anywhere from $100 to $200 a month, depending on how big your home is and how warm you like it. My house is always cold, so I'm always cold. But anyway, you can actually save a lot of money even through heat if you do electrical heat instead of the gas heat. Statistics about renewable energy can actually be really scary, but they can also be really relieving. Like Hammond states that in 2008, about 18% of global energy consumption came from renewable energy sources. And 13% came from traditional biomass like wood burning. Hydroelectricity was one of the next largest renewable resources, providing 15% of global electricity generation, followed by solar, hot water, and heating, which contributed to 1.3% of geothermal, wind, solar, and ocean energy, which provided 0.8% of final energy consumption. The writers from Science Direct say that in order to meet rapidly rising global energy